Welcome to DataViz Daily. I'm Kevin McGinley, and if you watched yesterday's episode, you saw me upgrade to the new version of Data Visualization Desktop 12.2.2. And so what I thought I'd do today is just give you a quick tour of what some of the differences are, new features or whatever in 12.2.2. Some of these things I'm going to cover more in depth in later episodes, and I'll go into some of more of these features in depth, but I just wanted to kind of give a sort of a quick walkthrough tour on some of the changes. So the first thing that you'll notice when you go into the new DV Desktop is we've got the search bar that was incorporated into OBIE 12C, the new homepage in OBIE 12C, which allows us to do things like start to actually create visualizations by searching on content here. So if I just start typing in speaker, for example, I can find the speaker column from a particular data set. If I do something like line count, I can find that particular measure from that same data set, and it will automatically create a visualization for me. And I can use that visualization as the mechanism to start a new DV project. So that's one thing that's a pretty cool new feature that we've seen come in from the sort of OBIE world into DV Desktop. So kind of walking through then, let's go over to the Data Sources tab, and we see a few new things here in terms of how our data sources are organized. We can, view them in sort of different methods now in terms of the different connection types. We've got something new here called Data Flows, which I'll get into more in future episodes. This is a capability that gives us some very lightweight ETL functionality within DV Desktop. It's a little bit different than the staging area that you've seen me go into in past episodes. We also have a lot of new connections, a lot of new connection types that Oracle's really introduced here. They've been really trying hard to increase the number of connections. So you can see here all the different connections. Some of these that have sort of migrated out of the beta world into a fully functioning supported connection. And as we scroll down the list here, we see a lot of new beta data connections. Things like Amazon, Actian, Cassandra, Google Cloud, HP Vertica, Informix, MapR, Microsoft Access, Postgres, Netezza, Teradata, Dropbox, Google Analytics, Google Drive. I'll start exploring some of these beta connectors in future episodes, but Oracle is clearly, really hitting the accelerator pedal on the number of data connections available in DV Desktop. So this is awesome to see. So if we go back over to the home screen here and just open one of our existing data visualizations, you'll see the first thing opens much quicker. The tool itself just feels very snappy as a whole, which is a great thing. And there's a few things that you'll notice that are different. The first thing is we have this new sort of prepare, visualize, narrate up in the upper right-hand corner, where our icons used to be, which have actually moved over to the left-hand side here. So we have a lot of the same icons that we had before, just moved from the right-hand side to the left-hand side. This drop down here allows us to get into some of those same property areas that we could get into before. And now we've got sort of a distinction between sort of preparing our data, which if we click on here, takes me into that sort of stage area that we talked about before. And we can do a lot of the same things that we did before. So I'll get into how data flows differ from these different capabilities within the staging area. But what's also nice is we can view it in two modes. We can look at it in data mode, but we can also look at it in visual mode. And I'll use some other data types or data sets to illustrate this better in the future, but this gives us an idea for what our data set looks like. And this is a pretty cool new feature as well. So back to the visualize area, you can see we have the option to have multiple canvases now. I'll show you where that comes into play and what use that has. You also notice a few things like they've changed the fonts up a little bit. We've got some other capabilities down here with regards to applying data and exploring the data and turning some of those things on and off from a filter perspective. And we'll get into the narrate capabilities, which I was intentionally sort of holding off, knowing that this version was coming. And we'll get into what those narration capabilities are like and creating insights and telling a story, but we'll save that for a future episode. So that's a quick walkthrough of the new DV Desktop 12.2.2, or DV Desktop 2.0 as we're sort of nicknaming it. I'm Kevin McGinley. Thanks for watching.